Chances are, we've all heard of carbohydrates, or carbs. Carbohydrates get a lot of attention in the nutrition world, so let's investigate the facts. A lot of people think of foods like pasta and rice when someone says carbohydrates. Sometimes carbs can be misunderstood and get labeled as bad for you. In reality, they play a very important role in human nutrition, and we couldn't live without them. The name carbohydrate is derived from the words carbon and water, because they're made up of those exact two things. All carbohydrates can be simplified to the chemical equation CxH2xOx. For example, the formula for glucose is C6H12O6. Remember when we said that you couldn't live without carbs? Believe it or not, roughly half of your calories should come from carbohydrates. That's a lot of carbs to eat. How come we need so much? Well, our bodies need energy. Say you're going to work out at the gym. Your body needs those carbs to fuel your body to push through that workout. Even for everyday tasks, carbohydrates are still needed to produce energy throughout the day. As we touched on before, bread, pasta, and potatoes are very well-known sources of carbs. But don't sleep on our fruits and veggies. Over half the calories in a lot of fruits and vegetables come from carbohydrates. Now that we've laid some groundwork, let's take a deeper dive into carbs. Take out a food item from your pantry or fridge. Something that's higher in carbs, like grains, fruits, and veggies, might make it easier. If there's a nutrition facts label on the package, see if you can find total carbohydrate. Under that, you should see dietary fiber and total sugars. These are two of the three subclasses of the nutrient carbohydrate. The third subclass is starch. Starch is comprised of many glucose units and is the storage form for glucose in plants. Common starchy foods are your pastas, potatoes, and white rice. Fiber is unique in that, although it's comprised of many glucose units linked together like starch, it actually can't be digested by the body, but it's still really important. Fiber helps strengthen the digestive tract and reduce blood cholesterol. Fiber can be further subdivided into soluble and insoluble fiber. The main difference between the two is that soluble fiber is soluble in water, while insoluble fiber is not. As the name implies, sugars aren't sugary foods. So food and drink like fruit, honey, and juice contain carbohydrates in the form of sugars. Unfortunately, sometimes the body runs into problems when regulating carbs. A common problem is called diabetes. Diabetes is when there is a malfunction regarding insulin production and/or uptake. Insulin is a hormone that is responsible for taking up glucose in the blood. The pancreas, the organ that releases insulin, may not produce enough insulin, resulting in blood glucose or blood sugar levels getting too high. This is called type 1 diabetes. Those with type 1 diabetes depend on injecting insulin into their body to make up for the lack of production by the pancreas. On the other hand, insulin may be adequately produced, but the cells aren't taking in the glucose, also resulting in high blood sugar. This is called type 2 diabetes, and it's the most common. Type 2 diabetes is not insulin dependent and is often associated with a sedentary lifestyle and obesity. By now, we can see that carbohydrates are pretty important to nutrition. In fact, they're essential. Ensuring that you get the right amount of carbohydrates and the best type of carbs can preserve and improve your health and well-being.